lives, they have no money if I die.
Rotate. You see, once you rotate, this grip is actually a weakened, it's a severely weakened grip. Actually here it starts to open up already. You can see the cavity here. Two fingers open up. Basically, Antonio is holding just with this little two fingers. That's why it's very easy to just remove it, and then this is a fair attack. We will strike you both sides of the face. So that's why I keep emphasizing to you guys, when you block, strike. I say,
don't block.
You always have one hand on the stick. Because this one hand, the left hand on the stick, is very critical, because you can take possession of the stick and control the stick. So being in the way of possess of the stick, we can, again, yeah. So, you know, you want to shoot me, overshoot the rifle, so that the rifle cannot be repositioned. Adjust it, then you're back to your shooting position, you know. So, but I don't want you guys to do things like, you know, think like this.
Yeah.
Because you just go back and aim at me, that's it, I'm dead.
You have no control.
I'm dead meat. So that's why if I were to be like this, I will overshoot the rifle. See? But overshoot, if you try to readjust, see, the rifle cannot get past me anymore. I'm in good hands.
Polio. My 8 wives, they have no money if I die.
So what do you do? You grab the weapon and then what?
I make sure it yeah, that's right. You rotate the thing.
Just
right.
Rotate it.
Rotate and then you smack him back again. You always want to stick fight in this angle. You rotate and you just shave his hand. He will like go, no matter how strong, how tough he is, we just shave right in his fingers. And sometimes we just shave and strike him together. He will let go. Grab the stick, rotate it, and then shift. That's right.
And then we can go kill the other guy. Go the other direction here.
Yeah. And then here. Shift. Nah, then smack him.
And then bam.
Yeah. And then take possession. And then.
What happens if the barrel is behind you?
Barrel is behind me?
The same principle.
You have to feel it though. You have to know where it is.
Yeah, if you don't know.
You have to know where it is. That's what sucks.
Same thing. Yeah. You just do the lift.
Can you do it from your knees, or do you have to stand up?
No, actually you can do one knee.
Ah, I see, I see.
This is the Japanese.
And now you're almost standing over
there. The quick drawing. Then you just
pull it away.
Then if you want, you can smack him in the face one time before you shoot him. From the right side, is we call it snaking. Mm-hmm. Okay? When you snake, don't do bad habits like snaking on the stick. This is snaking on the stick. This is wrong. Mm-mm. Because your hand is still free. If Antonio wants to jam me, Antonio just jams me now. And pummels me with the left hand. I did shit already. That's right. So that's why don't ever snake on the stick. You want to snake, you snake all the way to the hand. You must touch his hand. You just, actually, all you need to do is just twist your body. You know? You just twist your body. That's right.
Not on the stick.
Not on the stick. You must have physical contact. That's right. As I would grab, since I'm blocking here this part of the stick, I grab possession of the stick and I rotate your stick downward. Go first. And then, this is using the butt. I will remove it from you. Here, instead of using the butt, I can also use the tip. And then, another version, that's all. That's right. And then if you want to use a tip. That's right. Move all the way in and then you just rip it off. It's the same.
Okay. My main problem with learning self-defense is that I've been a fighter my whole life, and my whole thing is punching and kicking, and it's not probably not the best thing, right? Okay, so if I'm here, I come here, and then I'm already almost there.
That's right.
Kick down.
And then you just bump him away, and then that's it. Then you're in full possession. The reason why I'm not in favor, I mean, it's not wrong, it's never wrong, nothing is wrong. If you do things like this, it's not wrong.
Yeah.
It's not wrong. But some people are pretty tough.
Yeah, sure.
You get some tough guys.
Sure.
And you wallop him and he's...
And it's nothing.
And nothing. He just run backwards. And then, oh man, I'm taking a full magazine here from him already.
Yeah.
So, for me, it's takes possession of
the
weapon.
Take possession of the weapon.
Yeah. Now we can talk about whacking and killing and all the whatever nonsense.
Yeah.
You know, I have this, I can talk whatever already.
Yeah.
So for me it's takes possession of the weapon.
Take possession of the weapon.
Yeah. Now we can talk about whacking and killing and all the whatever nonsense.
Yeah.
You know, I have this, I can talk whatever I want to talk already.
Yeah.
You have to listen.
I strongly agree with you. I absolutely agree with you. So the most important thing is get the weapon away from the guy.
Yeah.
So, but if he's behind you, man, you got to feel it if you don't know where he is.
Yes.
Here, all right, and if we're here, let's see. Rotate.
Yeah, that's right.
Push in.
That's right.
Push in. And then the other one.
Oh,
that would be embarrassing.
I was just testing you.
That would be embarrassing. Flies, mosquitoes. I'll be happy after you shoot me. Stupid mosquitoes.
It's your forearm. Whole forearm.
Just knock it out of the way.
Okay.
Okay.
Or whatever you want to do, up to you.
And the M16 has this handy handle right here. It's designed for this.
Stoner really did a good job out of it, you know?
Hey, if the folks at home want to buy one of these, what's the procedure? They can write to you or
they can write to me.
Yew Jin made this himself out of paper mache. Oh, and he's got the matching pistol, thank you.
Yeah.
And actually for the set, how much for the set? If they buy them together.
The big ones and the small ones.
Okay, order now. You know what you do, just email me your credit card number, we'll take care of everything else. I promise.
One of the basic, I mean of course you plead your innocence or you plead mercy and everything. Move inside, I always say move inside, you do not move here and then. If I push it, he readjusts himself. I'm dipshit. So that's why we always move inside. Even he reposition himself. See,
yep.
I'm charging him. I will never get shot because I'm always out of the way. Rotate over your head, above your head. That's when you slap him.
Ouch.
Wow.
Ouch.
Okay. So, wow. But actually when you slap, the objective of this slap is, the face is one, but actually you're going for.
Oh, yeah.
Wrist.
Wow.
Yeah.
So, I'm not going to sweat.
You have a tough job,
okay,
man.
So, smack him right in the face then. That will stun him. Most people get slapped in the face.
With the 1911, they used to teach us that...
The trigger, jab
you
the trigger.
You can... Right here.
Yeah, you can.
You push the slide back and then it's not... With the Glock...
You're taking a gamble.
But you are taking a gamble.
You can recognize the gun. You know the gun. You know.
Yeah.
In reality, you just don't know. There are so many imitation guns in the market. There are so many variety. There are so many, you know, manufacturers. It's just that, to me, I assume the gun is a gun.
Yeah.
And it's gonna fire.
So on the old military 911, this top slide, 1911.
Yeah.
Sorry. So the same thing. You move away in this, but you go back like this, and it pushes the slide back, and it can't be fired. But as Yew Jin said, that's probably risky. But, I mean, this wouldn't be a bad position to be in, right?
Yeah, it's not bad. But I will be more efficient is once I grab hold of this, I will smack him.
Yeah, I like that.
That would stun most people that I know of in the market.
So if I'm here. Okay, so if I did that, now I got him going down.
Okay, now it's if. Ideally, is to get the gun, but
okay.
But shit happens, okay?
Can I decisively
the gun? Yeah, and then just drop your body weight on him. But this is... Yeah.
Self-defense.
One, two, three, four.